The Gram stain is a simple microbiology technique used to differentiate between gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria based on how cells stain. For the Gram stain, you will need the materials listed here. To begin, sanitize the bench. Cleaning the workspace is essential when working with microbes to retain sterile conditions. Next, pour a small amount of water into the beaker. Using a permanent marker, label the slide with the sample name or the organism being tested. Using a match, light the alcohol lamp. Place the tip of the loop into the flame until it glows red. Using the loop, place a small drop of water onto the slide. Lightly tap to transfer. After transferring the water, reflame the loop until it glows red. Allow the loop to briefly cool, pick up the glass tube, remove the lid, and gently flame sterilize the opening. Insert the loop into the tube without touching the sides and gather a small amount of bacteria from the slant. After removing the loop, gently flame sterilize the opening of the glass tube and return the cap. Next, pick up the slide and add the bacteria to the water droplet. Mix and smear into a very thin layer. Creating a thin layer promotes drying as well as reducing clumps of bacteria. After creating the smear, reflame the loop until it glows red. Allow the slide to air dry until it looks hazy with no water droplets. Next, the sample needs to be heat fixed. This is done by passing the slide through the flame 2 or 3 times. In this way, it allows the bacteria to stick to the slide. However, if the slide becomes too hot to the touch, you'll need to restart, as the bacteria have been cooked. Working over a sink or beaker, flood the slide with crystal violet to cover the bacterial smear. Allow to stain for 1 minute. After 1 minute, rinse the crystal violet away with water until the water running off the slide is clear. Take care to avoid directly spraying the smear with a jet of water when rinsing, as the bacteria in the smear can be washed off. Flood the slide with Gram's iodine to cover the bacterial smear and allow to stain for 1 minute. Rinse the Gram's iodine away with water until the water running off the slide is clear. Decolorize the sample with ethanol, which dissolves the outer membrane and washes away the crystal violet from gram-negative bacteria. This must be done quickly to not decolorize gram-positive bacteria. With a dropper full of ethanol, hold the slide at a 45-degree angle and apply to the top. The sample is decolorized when the liquid running off the slide is faintly purple. It should take less than 30 seconds. To stop decolorizing, quickly rinse the ethanol away, taking care when rinsing to not wash away the smear. Flood the slide with safranin to cover the bacterial smear and allow to stain for 1 minute. The safranin will stain the decolorized gram-negative bacteria pink. Rinse the safranin away with water until the water running off the slide is clear. Now the slide needs to be dried. Place within the bibulous paper and close the booklet. Lightly press, but do not rub. Carefully remove the slide from the bibulous paper. The bacteria on the slide can now be viewed using oil immersion. Both gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria contain peptidoglycan in their cell walls, which is stained with crystal violet. In this gram-positive cross-section, notice the thick layer of peptidoglycan in orange on the outside of the cell membrane. Gram-negative bacteria have an inner cell membrane, a thin layer of peptidoglycan, and an outer membrane. This outer membrane is dissolved, and the thin layer of peptidoglycan loses crystal violet when decolorized. Safranin was used to counterstain the gram-negative cells pink to make them visible. Here is an example of gram-negative bacteria stained. Notice the pink color. This is an example of a mixed culture showing both gram-negative and gram-positive bacteria. Note the differences in cell shape, size, and color.